Chances are, if you are able-bodied and I asked you to pick up these two cups, you wouldn't have a lot of issues doing so. After all, they're right here for you to see. However, it turns out that teaching an algorithm to do the same thing would actually be somewhat challenging when it comes to this cup in particular. And that is because these algorithms don't see objects the same ways that we do. But it turns out with some interesting tweaks to our models, we can actually teach algorithms to see this cup and pick it up just as easily as this one. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Jordan, and I talk about emerging technology, artificial intelligence, and what it's like to be a PhD student when it comes to productivity, mental health, and ADHD. So if any of that sounds interesting to you, you should subscribe down below so that you can stay up to date with all my videos. So if you haven't already guessed, the difference between these two cups is that this mug is not transparent and this glass is. And it turns out that seeing transparent objects is actually kind of complicated when it comes to algorithms. Specifically, a lot of computer vision systems use optical sensors like LiDAR to create 3D maps of their surroundings by estimating the depth of the objects in view. However, many of these systems assume that the objects they are trying to measure reflect light the same way in all directions, regardless of the angle that you happen to be looking at the object at. However, transparent objects don't do this. Instead of just reflecting light, they actually reflect and refract light, which makes it difficult for algorithms to process the information that the depth sensors are relaying. And interestingly, this doesn't actually just apply to things like glasses, it also applies to shiny objects and snow, which is actually why designing autonomous car systems happens to be pretty challenging when it comes to weather and reflections off of the road. In an effort to address this challenge, researchers at Google AI, Columbia University, and a company called Synthesis AI developed a model called ClearGrasp that accurately identifies transparent objects. Instead of relying purely on data from the optical sensors, ClearGrasp was trained to detect the boundary of each object and estimate the surface normal in order to get a more accurate view, so to speak, of every object in the image. And interestingly, the researchers actually used synthetic data to initially train their model because getting real-world data for these types of tasks can be relatively challenging and fairly expensive. From there, they tested ClearGrasp on both objects that it had seen in the synthetic data as well as new objects that it had not encountered before, finding that it was significantly better at both identifying and allowing a robotic arm to grasp these objects correctly. Now, even though the ClearGrasp algorithm was originally developed to help robotic systems more accurately pick up objects and identify them, this isn't the only situation where having computer vision systems that can identify transparent objects would be pretty useful. In fact, one of the places where it would be really useful is in the challenge of identifying plastic waste in large bodies of water. Now, this is normally where I would tell you about CuriosityStream and Nebula, but CuriosityStream has kindly agreed to donate their sponsor time so I can tell you about Team Seas. Team Seas is a global campaign to raise $30 million to remove 30 million pounds of plastic and trash from our oceans, beaches, and rivers. And if this sounds familiar, it's because Team Seas is actually the second wave of the largest creator-led fundraising effort, Team Trees. We launched Team Trees in 2019 with the goal of raising $20 million to plant 20 million trees, and we're able to totally surpass that goal, with TeamTrees.org still receiving enough donations to plant 2,600 trees per day today. This year, we're raising the bar to $30 million to clean up our oceans, rivers, and beaches, which are full of plastic trash. And to tackle those 30 million pounds of plastic and trash, Team Seas is partnering with the Ocean Conservatory and the Ocean Cleanup, with all donations being split 50-50 between the two charities. The Ocean Conservatory will be leading the effort to clean up beaches and oceans by sending professional crews out to clean up beaches and remove abandoned fishing gear from oceans. And the Ocean Cleanup will be leading the effort to clean up rivers using their interceptors, which actually use machine learning to identify and remove plastic waste from bodies of water. So if you'd like to donate or learn more about how plastic and trash affect our oceans, rivers, and beaches, you can click right here to head on over to TeamSeas.org, or you can actually click on the YouTube fundraiser, which should be on the side, whichever side, of this video. If you're interested in checking out last year's campaign, you can also check out the video that I did for Team Trees on using artificial intelligence to visualize the impacts of climate change in our local communities, and you can follow me on all my various socials down below. Otherwise, I will see y'all next week. Bye.